Hey vlog, so I literally have been so busy today. At first I was only supposed to shoot in the morning, but then at first I was editing. I wanted to finish this edit before I left home, and I thought that I was just gonna finish like a portion of it, but it turns out I was so close to like finishing like in full that I thought to myself, I'm like, why don't I just finish it so that when I go out and shoot I can be like worry free. So that's what I did, and then also it helped that the weather was not clearing up. So right now I'm downtown and it is sunny, so it helped that when I was in the house it was not sunny at all, so there was really no rush. Like, it said it wasn't gonna clear up until like 2 or 3 o'clock. Right now it's 4 o'clock though, so it did take me a little bit longer to get ready, but it's all good. The sun isn't going down anytime soon. So I found this area in downtown where I had wanted to shoot at. So right now I just parked my car for an hour and I'm going to go and try and get these shots. The sun keeps on moving though, as you guys can see, but I think that it'll come out good regardless. And I do have my little like clicker thing, so that should make shooting much easier. This is my first time like actually shooting in the city like for real though, so it should be interesting just to see like if there's like a bunch of people walking around or like different things like that. So yeah, I'm looking forward to it. Right now I am wearing this like white tank top bodysuit thing and some white jeans, and I'm wearing this purple jacket that my aunt got for me. The purpose of today's video is to show you guys how to take bomb photos of yourself. So a lot of the times I know that people can want to like have pictures of themselves, especially if you're like looking into like influencing. I personally just love to take pictures, and like even though I'm usually taking them of people, it's nice to switch the camera around and have them of myself. I've literally been doing this since like high school. So this is a way that if you don't have a friend to come along with you, or if you don't have a photographer, don't feel like you can't have bomb photos. So this is basically showing you guys how I take pictures of myself and showing the process. So I do have my regular camera, and this is my vlog camera that I'll like place on my little mini tripod on the floor. Hopefully it doesn't blow away because it is kind of windy today. Oh, the sun is coming back, y'all. So before the sun fully goes away, I think I'm gonna get out the car, use the most out of this time, and go ahead and shoot. So yeah guys, I hope that you enjoy this video. The first thing that I want to do is going to be getting set up. So that's gonna be setting up my regular camera, my main camera, and then also setting up my vlog camera to be positioned in the proper place. All right guys, so now I'm gonna go ahead, and this is my tripod, go ahead and set that up. So I do have it in the orientation where you get to take pictures like sideways, and I think that that's the best format that I like, just because you're able to get like that optimal like Instagrammable picture versus having a wide angle, but it's all up to you. Obviously, if you do have a tripod, it's good to have one that can tilt. So that's going, one that goes like this, so it tilts and swivels. So yeah, but again, like I said, I'm gonna keep it in this orientation. You want to make sure it's really tight, especially if you have a heavy camera. My camera is really heavy, so I keep it on very, very tight. I feel like I'm literally in the best possible spot because the sun is literally peeking through like right here. So I'm going to try and be quick with this just because I don't want the sun to go away, and also because, you know, I want to be rush hour. This is the clicker that I'll be using, so I'll be able to take... I just realized that you guys can't even see my face, but this is the clicker that I'm going to be using, so I'll be able to take my photos for myself. So right now, yeah, so I can find the most best optimal lighting. I'm going to kind of just move my camera around and kind of take test shots first, just to see what the best angles are. And also, I think it's important to like know your facial poses and whatever poses that you usually normally do. Definitely practicing in the mirror. I'm someone who just also just likes to pose a lot, so it's easy for me to come up with poses. But if you're not familiar with that, definitely like look at pictures of like what you would feel comfortable doing, and then you can kind of mimic that. If not, just kind of just be free as long as you're comfortable. Don't try to force yourself to like look like someone else, more so like just find inspiration, like poses to do, and based on what you're wearing too. If you're wearing like a flowy dress, you can kind of do the thing. If me, I'm wearing this jacket, you can kind of just grip on the jacket. So little things like that, definitely playing off of your clothes will definitely help you feel more confident and more ready to get the shots. Alright guys, I think that I found one of my really good angles, so I just took a test shot. So I'll show you guys the test shot. Actually, I just kind of stood in front. I wish I had marked down the spot, but I also don't want to have to Photoshop that out. But this is what the test shot looks like.
Now I know that I just need to angle the camera downwards so I can get more of my body into it.
So guys, those pictures actually came out decent, but the lighting was trash, so now I'm gonna go ahead and turn it around, and we'll see how these come out. So far, so good, guys!
Look at this clarity. Like, what's, who is she? Okay.
So when shooting for yourself, something to keep in mind too is that you should always have spare memory cards and spare batteries, because I didn't even know that one of my memory cards was running low on memory. I'm gonna go ahead. Thankfully, I do carry my Pelican memory card case with me. Guys, the visual just got right now are like literally amazing. I cannot wait to show you guys, and I cannot wait to edit it. This is literally the perfect location. I'm so happy. It's actually funny because I didn't even know that this was like Procter & Gamble's headquarters, and like literally 3 security people have come up to me like, excuse me, you need to exit the premises, da da da, this and that. You can stay on the sidewalk. So I'm literally on the sidewalk, and I didn't even know that I was gonna be using this background instead, but it literally worked out so perfectly. So I'm gonna go ahead and change my memory card and then continue to show you guys the shots that I'm getting. It's not for me to say.